Hello friends, welcome to Literary Visions. In today's video, we will discuss about all the important tales of Chaucer's magnum opus Canterbury Tales. First tale of Chaucer's Canterbury Tale is Knight's Tale. आपको यहाँ पे दो चीजें ध्यान रखनी है. Number one, the first tale of Chaucer's Canterbury Tale is Knight's Tale. Number two, it's a high romance told in heroic couplet. Now let's look at the Knight's Tale. So knights tell about the two friends Polomen and Arkite, who are knights from Thebes, and they go to visit Athens. There they are imprisoned by the Duke of Athens, who is called Theseus. They are sitting in the imprisonment, and they both fall in love with Emily. So these two friends fall in love with the same girl. And this love caused tension between both of them. So they finally decide they should engage in a battle and fight for Emily. जो भी बैटल का विनर होगा वही एमिली से शादी कर सकता है. After that, Arkite wins the battle, but due to divine intervention, an earthquake sort of things happen and Arkite dies. And at that moment, finally, Polomen becomes Emily's husband. Next tale, we have Wife of Bath's tale. The name of Wife of Bath is Alison, and she is also called Madam Gossip. Gossip basically means a close friend or gossip. Okay. And she talks about three important things before she tells her story. So first thing, she talks about the position of women in society. Second thing, she discuss about virginity, or we can say chastity. According to her, in order to remain chaste, we don't need to be virgin. Third thing, she talks about her five husbands. Yes guys, she married for five times. And name of her fifth husband is Jinkin. She fall in love with a person named Jinkin at the cremation of her fourth husband. You must remember that she has been represented as adulterous lady. Why adulterous lady? Because she calls all her marriages experience. Her story was at 56 lines story, and now she finally talks about the story. So she tells a story of a young knight of King Arthur's court who has raped a maiden. And in order to attend his crime, Arthur Queen sent him on a quest to discover what women want most. So he goes and try to look for an answer. Finally, he meets an ugly old woman who promised to the knight that she will give the answer, but only if the knight will promise that she will do whatever she tells him to do. Now he agrees in order to save his life. At this point, that woman finally tells him if women want most is to control the life of their husband. Now the old woman tells the knight that he should marry her because this is what she wants. And she transformed into a very beautiful and a faithful lady. Now we will move forward towards the Nun Priest tale. So Nun Priest tale is a beast fable. So there is a chicken, Chanticleer, and he has got seven wives, seven female chicken. Favorite of those seven wives is Pertelote. One night, Chanticleer wakes up from sleep and he had a bad dream, which he shares with Pertelote. And he tells that he had dreamed that a fox has eaten him. Pertelote tries to calm him. Chanticleer goes to the farm and there he finds a fox. Fox is sitting and started praising Chanticleer and asks him to sing for him. And Chanticleer agrees and closes his eyes and starts to sing. The fox taken the opportunity to catch him and grab him, and fox starts running. And Chanticleer decides to do something with fox. And he said to fox that, just tell me how you caught me and how did you get the idea. Now the fox opens her mouth to tell the story and the Chanticleer flies into a tree. Now the next tale is the Nun Prioress tale. and there is a bracelet hanging around his waist which has a brooch in it, and it's written on brooch that Amora vincet omnia. It's a Latin phrase which means love conquers all. And she first described the Jewish quarter where there was a small Christian school. A boy went to the school, loved to sing Alma Redemptor, that is a Christian prayer. And Jewish people keep seeing this boy singing Alma Redemptor, which angered them. So finally they decide hire someone to cut the boy's throat and to murder him. They kill the boy and throw the boy in a sewer ditch. And the boy's mother searches for the boy and eventually finds the boy's body. When she starts singing Alma Redemptor, his son joins her. The guilty men are executed. Here we discover that Virgin Mary placed a seed on boy's tongue, which allowed him to talk after he died. When the seed removed, the boy passes on to heaven and his body is buried. That is all about the Friar's Tale. Next tale is the Friar's Tale. So when the story starts, Friar is quarreling with Sumner. He arranges the marriage for the women. He was not a good character. Now you are wondered that how can I say that he was not a good man, because he arranges marriages for the women. But guys, on his coast, he would make them sleep with him first. That's why he was not a good man. Next character, we have the Doctor of Physics. So, Doctor of Physics tells simply a boring story of Appius and the Virginia. And in this story, a daughter is killed by a father rather than surrendered for a lusty, corrupt judge. And Doctor of Physics is also a negative character because he was also similar to the friar. So guys, that's all about the Chaucer's magnum opus, Important Pilgrims and Their Tales. I hope this will help you in your preparation. And if you like our video, then please like, share and subscribe so you never miss an update. Happy learning and stay tuned to Literary Visions.